This is a taillight fastener for a Lancia Monte Carlo and Scorpion taillight lens, also used on the Bitter SC. And I'm going to make 300 of these for bitter-parts.com.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Do you ever get home with all your things, but you have nowhere to set them? So it all just ends up in an ugly, disorganized, and hard to work with pile like this, causing you unneeded stress? Well, don't let it ruin your life. Get an Alfred backpack hanger today.
Did you know this episode's sponsor, PCBWay, offers injection molding services, including plastic molding, liquid silicone rubber, as well as insert and overmolding? They offer a wide range of plastic materials, from hard to soft and flexible varieties. Additionally, they offer a wide range of SPI mold surface finishes as well. Check them out for your next project. Link in the description below. These are the fasteners that hold these Lancia taillights in place. And I need to figure out what kind of a fastener is in here. So look away if you are offended by what I'm doing. I need to get a good look at what one of these fasteners looks like so we can order some. My client will order them and then we'll use them to make new ones. This is what these little buggers look like. In CAD, I've built a splitter board, and you can see it's even keyed on the one side with the little dot there, and this is where all the fasteners are going to go into to make the mold to replicate these things, right? We've got to make 100 in orange, 100 in clear, and 100 in red. Put a little bit of white glue on the backs of these things and we'll drop them into the 3D printed splitter board that I printed on my bamboo carbon, X1 carbon, nice printer, link below to get one. And then I'm gonna slide right into my magnetic mold box system, and I'm using BJB's 5150 silicone here. We're gonna mix some up, it doesn't take a lot. And this is relatively stiff silicone, 50 Shure A durometer silicone. And we're gonna make the mold out of this material. Let's go ahead and put that into the vacuum tank and degas it to remove the air bubbles. Make sure you degas your silicone really well to get all the air bubbles out so that you can get a good silicone mold. I'm pouring from one location and I'm letting that silicone flow out over the parts in the splitter board. I've got a dental vibration tool right next to my mold and I'm vibrating any bubbles that are in there to the top surface so I get a bubble-free silicone mold. All right, the mold has cured overnight, more than likely here about 12 hours, and we're gonna pull it apart. Really easy to do with this magnetic mold box system. Pull the sides off. Now our goal here is to just remove the splitter board and leave the original parts in place, and I'm trying to do that, so I'm just pressing on the parts with a wooden block so I can keep those fasteners in place and they don't all stay in place, but that's the name of the game. That's what you want. So I've 3D printed on my Formlabs some sprues, some pour sprues, and the vents are copper wire. They're 1 millimeter in diameter, and I'm super gluing those on. So we're gonna pour low. So this is where the pour sprue goes, and this is where the vent goes at the top, so they go across from each other so they have the best chance of filling with resin and then venting correctly. So we do that to each one, so that we have some place to pour the resin into and the excess resin can flow out of and remove all the air that's trapped inside of it, and we can get a good, successful fastener. Now, I need to very delicately add some release agent to the silicone so that when we pour the second half of the silicone, we don't get that silicone sticking to it. So we're gonna mix up some more BJ1 5150. I will tell you that I did end up with some cure inhibition here against those 3D printed pour sprues. They should have been coated with shellac, and it didn't cure fully. Now, it didn't prevent me from making the parts, but it did slow things down a little bit. Okay, let's remove that and see how our mold turned out. Easy to pop the sides off, and now we want to pull out all the vent sprues, and we got to pull out the pour sprues. We'll take everything apart, and that should leave us a nice mold, and we'll remove the original parts from the mold, and they just twist out. And this is where we're going to insert fasteners in the future, and then our resin behind those to make new fasteners. All right, there's the molds. Let's mix up a little bit of resin here. I got them using some clear, and we're going to inject in, and you can see the resin comes out the vents and into the pressure tank it goes to cure with heat. I have to make 300 of these, right? 100 of each color. I need a second mold. So I'm going to make one out of some 1040. This is a tin cure silicone. And the main reason I'm using this is because I happen to have it, but it also, I know I won't have any cure inhibition issues with the tin cure here against the pour sprues that are 3D printed. Basically, the procedure is exactly the same as before. I'm just using a different silicone to make these molds. I'm adding some release agent to the silicone here so that when we pour the second half, we're not going to get any adhesion from the silicone, really, or any. Because the only thing that sticks to silicone is silicone. So you need to make sure that you have put your release agent on your silicone so that when you pour more silicone onto it, it doesn't firmly grip in and you can't take the mold apart. So again, pour from one place and let that silicone flow out. I have a vibration tool right next to this thing. It's just outside the frame, but it is bubbling up any bubbles in that silicone to the top surface. So once that's cured overnight, take things apart and we'll take a look at this second mold that's going to help me make all the parts in addition to the first mold that I have already. Remove all the vents and the sprues. We'll take a look at what we got. Of course, these are all the original parts. We're going to remove them. I can see there's one part here that's bad, and we'll just always get one bad one in each mold, in each batch, so to speak. All right, the resin is loaded into a syringe, and that's how I inject it into the pour sprue, into the cavity to create the parts. All right, this is the pressure tank. We're taking it out of the pressure tank after the parts have cured for at least 4 to 6 hours with some heat, maybe 110, 120 F, and we'll pull them out. We'll see what we get. Oh, look, orange parts. The process is the same, just a different resin color. All right, let's see what we got. Look at this. Nice little orange fasteners. I'm gonna use a drill, make make things a lot easier. So there's a little bit of flash on each one, but it's very easy. It breaks off, and you can see the reject one there in the middle row. That's always bad, but that's what the parts are. Come out pretty nice. We'll add them to the container. And I'm on my way to making 100 orange fasteners. Only need to do this several more times. You may be curious, how do we get the vented resin and the resin from the pour sprues out? So I have a special tool. It's maybe 1.5 millimeters in diameter here. It's a piano wire, and I poke the resin that is in the mold out. The pour vents are easy. It's the regular vents that are difficult. And we gotta blow out any resin that is in there from the flash, and then we put our screws in to make the next batch. So I just pop them in, screw them down a little bit. In this case, I'm just pushing them down. Get them to the right height. Close the mold. And we can go for the next set. All right, let's see. Again, orange. So loaded it up in a syringe. You saw me just suck it up out of the cup. And then I want to quickly get this resin into the mold. I'm using a fast set resin here. So only about 5 to 7 minute work life. Now, because we're using a modern fastener, the threads are actually different on these very slightly. They don't have quite the same pitch. And so when the parts are molded, they get resin into them, and we need to remove the resin. So what I've made here out of a block of aluminum and an old X-Acto blade and a hole is a tool that will remove the resin from the threads, and this allows you to see how that works. I screw it in, and then the edge of the X-Acto basically gouges out the resin that is in each of the parts. And the fasteners are all stainless steel, where the other ones were plated, maybe like CAD plated or something like that. And so these fasteners should be better than the original ones. So you have to do this to all 300 of them. My client volunteered to do them, but I did do a few here when I tested out the tool to make sure that it works. And that's how we remove the resin from the fasteners. Bag them up, 100 of each, send them off to my client. And this was all part of that same project, making these Lancia Scorpion Monte Carlo taillights. This is the assembly, so you can see where the fasteners go to hold the taillights in place, or the lenses, I should say, in place on the taillight assembly. I only made the lenses, and that was the previous video. And you can go back and you can watch that if you want to see how these lenses are made. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Don't forget to follow me on social media at Bots and Design. I'm now on Blue Sky, and unfortunately still on Instagram. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.